Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My first two songs are both by Henrys. The first one is I Attempt From Love Sickness to Fly by Henry Purcell. Now, he was born in London around 1659 and succeeded his teacher Blow as organist of Westminster Abbey in 1679. And while I was looking him up in the dictionary, I found something interesting about him. Legend has it that his death was of a cold caused by his wife, indirectly, who locked him out in the cold when he returned home one night, worse for drink. It's about love and bitterness, and it says, love has more power and less mercy than fate to make us seek ruin. The second song is about unrequited love, and it's called I Prithee Send Me Back My Heart by Henry Lawes. He was born in Wiltshire in 1595, and his most famous piece is probably Zadok the Priest, which was written for the coronation of Charles II. So the first one's I Prithee Send Me Back, sorry, I Attempt From Love Sickness to Fly. I attempt from love sickness to fly in vain, since I am myself my own fever, since I am myself my own fever and pain. No more now, no more now, fond heart, with pride and swell, thou canst not raise forces. Thou canst not raise forces enough to repel. I attempt from love sickness to fly in vain, since I am myself my own fever, since I am myself my own fever. Songs that were written by Thomas Moore. He was born in Dublin in 1779 and was a poet, and he was largely a self-taught musician. He wrote one opera called The Blue Stocking with Charles Horne, who you'll hear from later on. But I think these next two songs were his best known. The first is Believe Me If All Those Endearing Young Charms, which he wrote the words of, but I believe the tune was written by someone else. It's about undying love, and the poet says, even if you lost all your charms tomorrow, around thy dear ruin, each word of my wish of my heart would entwine itself verdantly still. The second song is 'Tis the Last Rose of Summer, for which Moore wrote both the words and the tune, and it's about being left all alone in this world, without anyone to love, and without anyone to love you.
Senseless and dead.
quite technical pitch. John Byron was not quite as prolific as Thomas Campion, who you heard earlier. He published 87 songs. He too was a Londoner, born around 1562 or 1563, and was a lute virtuoso, being the lutenist of the king to the King of Denmark for some time. Do you know any kings, John? Good job. My first Byron song is again a well-known choral madrigal, and the words beg for lost love to return, and it's called Come Again. The other is Awake Sweet Love, and in some ways complements the first, as it's about love who's returned, she just having played with the singer's affections.
Sweet love, doth bow in white.
Better known than that. It's like most songs tonight, it's about love. And it's written by another Londoner, Charles Edward Hall. He was born there in 1786. He was an actor, a singer, who worked extensively in New York and Boston, where he conducted the Handel Haydn Society of Boston for a while. He worked on the opera, The Blue Stocking, which I mentioned earlier, and with Thomas More, but this song was first sung in 1826 by somebody called Lucia Vestris in the production of Paul Pry. Unlike most of these other love songs tonight, it's about someone being in love and being actually happy about it, which is unusual. I will. It's called Cherry Rock.
Yeah.
It's time for us all to do a song together now. This song is from my home county of Somerset. It's not a Rosa song, no. It's a Somerset folk song, one of the songs collected by Cecil Sharp. It's all about courtship. It's got an exclamation mark after the title, although it's not on your programme, I noticed. And John will often come up to me and Terry and give us a piece of music and say, what do you think of this? Do you think we can do this? To which our reply is often succinct to the point, oh no, John.
For her beauty, she must answer yes.